in the show that we made for you. For your mom and your dad and your auntie Sue. So grab yourself a coffee, it's a crack of dawn, and strap yourself in for a hit's good morning.
It's another heaps good Sunday morning, and yet again we're here to delight and entertain, but not inform, as I have no one here insisting me to do so. That's right, I'm all by my lonesome savvy, but not for long. The following episode was so long that we decided to split it into two. And when it came to filming a new intro for this episode, unfortunately Mercedes was too busy going on a camping holiday. Bitch. So I have been trusted to do the intro by myself on two conditions. One being that I don't steal the spotlight, which is kind of handy because we've only got these diffuser ones on the side here. We don't have any spotlights. And that I keep it short, sharp and shiny, which I intend to do so. Ooh, that's a little bit hot. Here's Thank God You're Here.
Struggle Town.
Okay, so shall we start off with some Thank God You're Here board game?
Sure, why not? Okay. Why the hell not?
All right, this is going to be very interesting, and it's probably going to be terrible. Now, would you like to know what character you are picking, or would you like to randomly choose a character?
Let's randomly choose a character.
Okay, so the idea is that you randomly choose one of these five. What have you chosen?
I'm on TV.
And you get the microphone. It's very cute. Oh, it looks a bit fake.
La, la, la. No, it's totally believable. It's like made out of air.
See, it's for when people do the microphone drop so they can do it without damaging the microphone. I think that's smart.
I think the mic drop's like passé now. I think people don't do it. I think it's a bit...
Oh, really?
Yeah. Oh, and like so that thing, what's that? The
dabbing? That can stay back in 2016, I reckon.
It is. I think mic drops are too.
Yeah. Well, that's probably 2015.
But was it?
I reckon. Okay, so I take...
Hey, that's my envelope!
Yes, and I take it now because I need my script. You don't get a script.
Oh, you guys saw how good I am at improvisation when we did that story thing at Christmas time. So this ought to be interesting. I feel like this microphone isn't going to last too terribly long.
Probably because
I've already broke it, so...
Oh, that's all right. It's all good. I've got real microphones anyway. Okay. All right, so you are... a beauty expert on a morning talk show. Of course, like any beauty expert, you are there to promote your fabulous new beauty product. Think plucked eyebrows, shiny skin, and it's time for making everyone believe they could look like a star. So we're on a morning talk show.
Okay.
Well, it's time to talk beauty, and who better to do that with than our head of Chrysalite Clinic?
It's Chrysalite Clinic.
Chrysalite Clinic. Clinic. Pauline.
I prefer Polly.
Polly? Oh, sorry, Polly. Polly.
Polly Ananucci.
Thank God you're here, Polly. Can you guess why I'm so excited?
Is it because you've had some of our... Chrysalite Clinic, drink yourself young.
Well, tonic? It could be some of that. It could be. But I'm excited because you've come up with an amazing breakthrough in skincare. It's not a facelift. It's not a face peel. No. What is it?
Duct tape. It's duct tape. You just take it and it's just the easiest thing ever. And you just, give yourself a little lift here. And a little bit here. You always want to get the clear tape, and it's here, and you look 20 years younger.
That's amazing. Yeah. Look, I wouldn't believe it if I didn't see it myself. It's a special new beauty treatment called Moxibrasion. What exactly is moxibrasion?
Well, moxibrasion is where you go out to the gay club and you find a bear.
Yeah.
That is especially moxy. And then you try to talk him into pashing you for a good hour. And the stubble just does amazing things with his skin.
It's like magic. It's like magical. And they say this treatment can take 5 years off a person's face. How?
Well, it depends on how woolly your bear is, really. But, you know, if you have a little bear cub, then, you know, you get 6 months out of it or something. But if you get, like, a real woolly bear, or I think they're called wolves. Wolves. Anyway, it can just totally remove the top layer of skin.
So it's like it just really gets in there.
It's like microdermabrasion, but the added benefit of the oils from the beard.
Oh, that sounds fantastic. Mm. Could it take 5 years off of my face?
Well, no. It's not magic.
Why don't you talk us through the process? Let's start with skin. What a lot of people don't realise is that skin is made up of three layers. The inner layer is called...
your soul.
Your soul? Okay. Yeah, and
sure.
Then there's a middle layer after the soul. What's your soul? What's
after your soul?
Yeah.
Is just, you know, banana peels.
Banana peels?
Yeah, sure.
So soul, then banana peels?
Soul, banana peels, and then makeup.
And makeup.
Yeah.
And it says finally, the epidermis, or to use a more common name.
Foundation.
Oh, okay. All right. I get it now. And what does moxibrasion do for these three layers?
Well, it just removes your skin.
All the three layers?
Yeah, just down to banana peel.
Just down to banana peel.
Yeah. Right, that's right. And then you just put a new layer of makeup on.
Oh, okay. And just like magic.
Yeah, makeup magic. No, I said not magic, but makeup magic.
Okay, makeup magic. Naturally, all moxibrasion treatments are carried out by fully trained operators. Some are dermatologists. What are the others?
Dermatologists, right. Well, we have a girl, her name's Ebony, and she went to TAFE for, you know, almost the whole skincare course. And so she's really good at, you know, winging it. And then we have, you know, Michelle, and she didn't go to TAFE, but, where she's from, you just, you know, you mix mud up and you put it on your face. It's a cultural thing, I think. I don't even think her real name's Michelle.
Oh.
But, and so we've got a really excellent team. It's very diverse.
Yeah. So how long does it take to become a, moxibrasion expert?
Well, I'm 37.
Brilliant. Thank you. The producer sound, but the procedure sounds quite painful. What do you do to make sure that patients don't feel much pain?
Well, you know, at the end of the session with the beard and stuff, we add a very natural lubricating moisturizer.
Oh, very sensual. Mm. Are there any negative side effects of the treatment?
Well, I don't think there are some, but the bears, they don't like it very much because, you know, we're not really their flavor.
Oh, I see. That could be a...
So that's hard, but we pay them a lot of money. That's why it's so expensive.
Oh, okay.
Anybody can be bought.
The dollars. Now, your clinic has been featured in all sorts of magazines and on TV. A Current Affair seems a little negative. Why was that?
Well, look. That guy and I dated on Current Affair. I won't mention any names because, you know, the lawsuit.
So, fair enough.
I just think he's bitter.
So you just think it's just a bit of tough bitter. Okay, fair enough.
Because I found out how old he really was. So,
but that hasn't stopped... How old was he? But that hasn't stopped many Australians lining up for moxibrasion anyway, including one of the highest profile politicians. Who was that?
Pauline Hanson. Yeah.
Meanwhile, some big names are coming from overseas to have the treatment because moxibrasion is actually banned in many countries. Why is that, Paulie?
Well, they're coming here because they can't have it done there.
Oh, well, that makes perfect sense, I guess. Unfortunately...
Nick Nolte is one of our big-name clients.
Oh.
Yeah, secretly he died 23 years ago, but nobody knows.
Wow.
Because of moxibustion.
Very nice, very nice. Unfortunately, moxibustion is not cheap, but you do offer an easy pay option. How do women pay it off?
I'm not at liberty to discuss that.
Oh, so it's a secret.
Our lawyers have advised us that until certain things are finalized, I'm not at liberty to discuss the payment plan.
Okay, so basically, if you want more information on that, you'll need to contact yourself or.
Sure.
Sure. Okay. Cool.
Not so me. I don't work the phone.
Well, of course not. But we can contact your company.
Yes.
Okay. Brilliant. And I believe you've got a bit of a surprise for us now. What is it?
Do.
Yeah, apparently you've got a bit of a surprise. It says so on my script.
Oh, nobody told me about that. Oh, my agent didn't clear this with me. Well, we're just bringing out a new product.
You're bringing out a new product?
Sure, why not?
Okay, you're not sure what it is yet?
I am sure. We're making our lubricating moisturizer available to the public now.
Ah, okay. And what's in you? What's...
Well, unfortunately, I'm not at liberty to discuss that just yet.
But does it have something to do with bears?
It does indeed.
Okay.
All the myths you've heard have always been true.
That could be good or very, very bad. The first 20 women who phone you up today will receive a special offer. What will you be offering them?
A pair of my worn panties.
Brilliant. That's fantastic. Well, it's been great catching up with you again, Paulie. Looking out for it, ladies. Just keep looking out for it. Moxibustion.
Yep. And I'm supposed to put this disclaimer out. Please don't approach bears on your own. And when I mean bears, I mean grizzly bears, black bears, and also the bears at the gay clubs. Don't approach them on your own. We have specific contracts with them. They find it really offensive.
There you go. You heard it here first. Moxibustion, ladies and gentlemen. And your slogan says, Moxibustion, more than a facelift, it's a...
life changer.
It's a life changer. Moxibustion. Go get some.
Get some.
Okay, so I guess it's my turn now, is it?
It's your turn.
And I am choosing to be... bitch.
Don't be like that.
I'm the hero.
Well, you're wearing a cape, so did Little Red Riding Hood.
Yeah, but capes, Little Red Riding Hood's cape wasn't as cool
as mine. Are you drunk today?
I feel it. I really do. I can't get my mouth words out.
Now,
Oh, well.
You are a famous movie star visiting Australia to promote your new blockbuster, A Time to Die. A journalist has arrived at your hotel to interview about the film. Time for another Oscar-winning performance. You ready? Oh, he's smug. Smug movie star. All right. Well, thank God you're here. I believe it's your first time in Australia. What are your initial impressions?
Sorry?
Your initial impressions of Australia? What are they? First time here?
Yeah. It's all right, eh? I'm getting in on their lingo.
Yeah, great. So, we haven't seen your film, A Time to Die. So, could you give me a brief description of your role?
Well...
No, plot. Sorry, not your role.
Of the plot? Basically, it's all based around this central clock tower that's in the middle of this fancy mystical land called London. And everyone stands under the clock tower and the clock tower collapses and everybody dies.
Right.
Get it? Time to die.
Yeah, I get it. Your Australian accent is very good, by the way.
I've had to put it on for...
It's been described as a heartwarming comedy with a twist.
Yes,
what's
very much.
What's the twist?
What's the twist? That it's not very funny.
Well, what sort of research was required for your part?
For my part?
I think so. I don't know.
Okay. For my part, yeah, I had to do a bit of research because, you know, they were wanting this very Australian-type superhero.
Yeah.
So they basically made me sit on out of the backyard on a lawn chair and drink some beers.
Your character... character is, of course, based on a remarkable person who I believe you were lucky enough to meet. Who was that?
Banjo Patterson. I had to go back in time to do that, so they had to put me in their time machine, and we went back and I saw Banjo Patterson, who's apparently some kind of Australian poet or something.
Well, that must have been interesting. Where did the meeting take place?
In a mystical land that was filled with witches and fairies.
That's where you met Banjo?
Yeah, well, you see, I tried to get to his timeline, but I couldn't actually get to his timeline. So they said, hey, how about if we organise this place somewhere in between where you guys can meet together? And they decided, hey, Pixie Land.
Yeah, excellent. So what was the most difficult thing you had to learn in order to play this part?
Speaking Australian.
Well, you've done a fantastic job of that. What was it like working with such an amazing co-star?
I'm sure it would have been fantastic if I knew who the co-star was, but it was a riot.
We heard there was a bit of tension on the set. What was that about?
Well, sometimes, you know, they don't like it because when I get into character, I try my best really to get into character. So I'm just punching on and you know, fists are gonna fly.
What did his trailer have that your trailer didn't?
A couple of extra hookers, I believe. But that's just because he cut a better deal than I did, I guess.
You did all of your own stunts in the film. Which one was the scariest?
The one where I had to put my cape up like this, and then I had to fly and jump off a building like this, because they run out of money for special effects. So the only way they could get me to look like I was flying is if I actually jumped, and I really badly broke my leg.
Oh, okay. I believe in the run-up to the film you put on 6 kilos, yet this wasn't actually required for the role. Why did you do that?
I was investing in my role a bit too much. Drank a bit too much beer.
Fair enough. Now, the film has just had its premiere at Cannes. You didn't have a red carpet premiere, but what did you have instead?
We just had hundreds and hundreds of party poppers all going off at the same time while people sang. And they sang this beautiful song called Amazing Grace. It was nice.
You're such an idiot. I believe that was picketed by various Christian groups. Why were they so upset, seeing as how you sang Amazing Grace?
Yeah, they just didn't like the way we sang it. They said we're out of key.
Oh, on a personal note, you've just had an addition to your family. Tell us about that.
Yeah, I've got a new lizard named Ezekiel, and he does this a lot on the glass.
Well, there's that, and you also adopted a child from Uganda, so...
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that, yeah.
Right, so you described this adoption as a dream come true. Why then did you send the child back 6 weeks later?
Well, you know, they're kids, they're handfuls, you know. You got to have a bit of a break yourself. So you just send them a packed lunch and get them on a plane and they just f*** off for a while.
Oh, okay. Final question then. You once said that as an actor, no amount of money would convince you to make an ad. Yet, you've just signed on as the new face of Bunnings Warehouse. How can you explain that?
Well, it's because... Basically, once again, trying to get into character, they really wanted me to, you know, get a feel for what it's like to be Australian. And they said, you know, Bunnings.
Do you get free snags?
I always get free snags. A guy comes up dressed like a superhero, you're just like, free snag, mate!
Well, thank you for your time and good luck with The Time to Die. What's the name of your next film?
Hooba Dooba Chooba Tubes. Check us out on Heaps Good Morning.
Well, thank God you were here.
Well, thank you, us. That was Thank God You're Here. I hope you enjoyed it. We weren't too sure how you were actually going to feel about it, as neither of us are real improvers, but we hope you enjoyed it all the same. Now, I know that Mercedes promised to have 2 plugs for local businesses in this episode, but because of the splitting of the episodes, They are in next week's episode. Sorry, I'm in such a rush trying to get this all done. I'm just kind of hyperventilating as I'm doing this. Because Mercedes isn't here to do her two for this week, I thought I would do one of my own. Sci-fi AI guy, who is one of my friends, Ryan Morrison, from way back in primary school. That would have been over 20 years ago now. But Ryan Morrison is a postgraduate student slash researcher in the field of science fiction and artificial intelligence. He plays science fiction games online and talks theory. You can go check him out on Twitch, which is there, or you can go and research Sci-Fi AI Guy on YouTube and find his videos that way. So that's the end of our episode for the day. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. Our future is at your godlike fingertips. We don't have reenactments, however, today, because you've already seen enough of our ugly mushes trying to do acting. So I'm just going to take you out from the desk here for the first time ever. So thank you for joining us on today's episode, and I hope you have a heaps good day. Ciao.